नमस्कार एंड वेलकम आई एथार सिक्का इन द नेक्स्ट फ्यू मिनट्स बी गेटिंग द टॉप न्यूज ऑफ द लास्ट 24 आवर्स। अ कंप्लेंट हैज बीन फाइल्ड अगेंस्ट बॉलीवुड एक्ट्रेस तापसी पन्नू फॉर हर्टिंग द रिलीजियस सेंटीमेंट आफ्टर शी डोंड अ नेकलेस विद माँ लक्ष्मी नेकलेस पेयर्ड विद अ रिवीलिंग सेट ऑफ क्लोथिंग। द बटला एक्ट्रेस हैज अपलोडेड अ पिक्चर एंड अ वीडियो ऑन मार्च 14 फ्रॉम द रैंप वॉक एट लैक्मे फैशन वीक हेल्ड ऑन मार्च 12 इन मुंबई। द रिलीजियस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हिंद रक्षक संगठन हैज फाइल्ड अ चार्ज अगेंस्ट तापसी पन्नू फॉर वायलेटिंग रिलीजियस इमोशंस एंड स्प्रेडिंग ऑब्सेनिटी। The Election Commission of India announced the schedule for the Karnataka Assembly elections on March 29. The Chief Election Commissioner Rajiv Kumar said that the polling would take place in a single phase on May 10. The Chief Election Commissioner also announced at a press conference that the counting of the vote would take place on May 13. Detailing of the data of the electorals, the CEC said that there are total 5.21 crore in the state and the number of 100 plus voters is 16,976. On March 24, the Andhra Pradesh government passed two resolutions, one for the extending the scheduled caste status to the scheduled caste members converted to Christianity and the other for the inclusion of Boya and Valmiki community in the list of scheduled tribe. The Andhra Pradesh government said in their resolution on the inclusion of scheduled caste convert to Christianity continue to retain their disabilities including untouchability and other economic and social backwardness even after the conversion, and therefore there is a strong legitimate basis for including them in the list of scheduled caste. The first batch of the Agnivir under the Indian Navy numbering 2,585 and which include 273 women underwent 16 weeks of rigorous training at INS Chiklia in Odisha. The Chief of Naval Staff Admiral R. Hari Kumar attended the passing out parade on May 28 after the sunset as the chief guest. The renowned athlete and the president of the Indian Olympic Association P.T. Usha and former captain of Indian women cricket team Mithali Raj also graced the function. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh is in full throttle mode. India would be exporting defence equipment and material worth ₹35,000 to ₹40,000 crore by 2026, Union Defence Minister Rajnath Singh said on May 28.
Vico Vajradanti. शायद इसमें आपको taste का मजा नहीं मिलेगा, झाग का मजा नहीं मिलेगा. अब आप सोचेंगे तो मिलेगा क्या? असर कम problems पर. इसकी 18 जड़ी बूटियां स्वोलन गम्स ब्लीडिंग गम्स जैसे प्रॉब्लम्स को रखे दूर और दांतों को रखे हेल्दी. मजा नहीं, असर. अब पेस्ट है, पिक्चर का टिकट थोड़ी.
वीको वज्रदंती, इंडिया का गम एक्सपर्ट.
मजेदार नहीं, असरदार.
After Unacademy BioJuice, now online education provider StudyIQ sparks controversy with Britishers United India remarks. An online tutor remarks on how Britishers United India is making rounds on the internet. This is not the only time that an online teaching organization or their tutor has sparked controversy. There have been big names to it like Unacademy, Vision IAS and StudyIQ. In the recent StudyIQ controversy, no apology letter has been issued by the organization. Some of the videos of the tutor identified as Divakar Bothra, who teaches at the digital education providing platform StudyIQ. Some of the clips and PDF from his classes are going viral on the internet. Karnataka Chief Minister Basavaraj Bommai on Wednesday exuded confidence in winning the state assembly polls slated to the take place on May 10 and said that the BJP is an ever-ready party which is prepared for the election. The Election Commission of India announced the schedule for the Karnataka assembly polls on Wednesday. The Chief Election Commissioner said that the polling will take place on May 10 and the counting of votes will be done on May 13. Khalistani separatist Amritpal Singh sought help and shelter from religious preachers in Uttarakhand as he continued to evade arrest. However, they refused to help him. According to the security agency sources, Amritpal requested the religious leader in Uttarakhand through some of his contacts to give him shelter. His request was turned down by the religious leaders. The Waris Punjabi chief has been on the run since the Punjab police launched a crackdown against Waris Punjabi chief on March 18. Khalistani separatist Amritpal Singh keeps slipping away from the police despite the authorities being on his hunt for more than 10 days. On Tuesday, he escaped from the authorities in the car which he ran past a police checkpost in Punjab's Hoshiarpur. Amritpal Singh and his aide Palpreet Singh used a network of women after they fled from the police in Jalandhar, informed sources. The threatening email that actor Salman Khan received on March 18 was sent by notorious gangster Koldi Barar, who carried out a murder of Punjabi singer and Congress leader Sidhu Moosewala in May last year, said the Mumbai police. The gangster is currently hiding in the UK, according to Mumbai police. India, despite many global challenges, is the fastest growing economy today. This itself is the best advertisement for the democracy in the world. This itself says that democracy can deliver, says PM Narendra Modi at a summit for democracy. Rahul Gandhi is the most unsuccessful, weak and careless and the arrogant leader of the Gandhi family. If this is not arrogance, then what is this? He insulted OBC people, he called the people of one whole caste thieves and refused to apologize. We will never forgive him or Congress, says MP CM Shivraj Singh Chauhan. In Karnataka, Election Commission's flying squad members have seized 35.5 lakh in cash from a car at a check post in Sedam and arrested three people. The state will vote in assembly election on May 10. India is committed to fulfilling our obligation under International North-South Transport Corridor and inclusion of Chabahar Post. India became the member of SCO in June 17, but our relations with SCO countries go back several centuries, says NSA Ajit Doval. Rahul Gandhi does the politics of entitlement. He thinks since he was born in a certain family, he is above the constitution, court and parliament. He also thinks that he is above the constitution of India, says Union Minister Ashwini Vaishnaw. We will be back with news at 9 tomorrow. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, and do not forget to like and share the video and subscribe to our channel.